Well, I think the reason we're here today, that the Ensign Amendment, the Gregg Amendments, strike at the very crux and the very core and the very heart of what this is all about. Because the Democrat majority was unwilling to take on the trial lawyers, unwilling to do things that actually bend the cost curve down, like capping contingency fees, we are faced with voting on the Ensign Amendment, which would do that. But we're also voting on the Gregg Amendment. Because they weren't willing to put actual measures in this bill that would bend the cost curve down, what they've had to resort to is cutting Medicare to pay for it. It's a $2.5 trillion expansion of the federal government, has to be financed somehow because there aren't any real cost-saving measures in here. And I want to point out to my colleagues exactly, in spite of all that, where we are. The Congressional Budget Office says that even with all the Medicare cuts and all the tax increases that are in here, we actually still increase spending in this country on health care. The cost curve goes up. The blue line represents the existing cost curve if nothing is done. If we did nothing today, that's what would happen. That's the blue line. The red line represents what happens under this bill. We actually raise the cost curve even more. Cost for health care in this country under this legislation go up $160 billion. Now, how does that affect the individual family? I want to show you exactly what this means in terms that I think most Americans can understand. This is the example of a family of four who today is paying a little over $13,000 for their health insurance. Under this bill, their life doesn't get any better. In the year 2016, they're going to be paying over $20,000 a year in health insurance. So what happens is they have locked in the status quo, and that status quo is year-over-year increases that are double the rate of inflation, all because they were unwilling to put measures in this bill that actually do control costs. Now, if we did something to along the lines of the Ensign Amendment that actually would get these contingency fees under control, and we all have statistics, the CBO has said that that would bend the cost curve down. We've all talked to physicians in our own state. I talked to a physician in my state last week who unsolicited said 50% of the tests that he does are to avoid being sued. 50% of the tests that he conducts are defensive medicine. That drives the cost of health care up for everybody. That's why the Ensign Amendment is so important. Unfortunately, why we have to vote on the Gregg Amendment. The Gregg Amendment forces the Democrats to put their money where their mouth is and to see if they really mean what they say, that they want all these savings in Medicare to go into Medicare. We all know that's not true. To pay for a $2.5 trillion expansion of the federal government and create an entirely new entitlement, you've got to take the cuts in Medicare and put them into this new entitlement program. And so we're voting on a couple of amendments today that will ensure that seniors in this country are not going to be faced with cuts to their benefits, home health care agencies, nursing homes, hospitals, all those that receive the cuts under this bill, and actually trying to substitute in there something that would get costs under control, would, according to the Congressional Budget Office, drive the cost curve down, would do something about these year-over-year, double the rate of inflation increases that the average American family is seeing. This is what the CBO says would happen to the average American family if this bill passes. Today, they're paying $13,000 a year for health insurance, a family of four. In the year 2016, they'll be paying over $20,000 a year. Tell me, how is that reform? How can anybody go to an average American family with a straight face and say, we are reforming health care, when all you're doing is locking in permanently year-over-year increases that are double the rate of inflation, and in some cases, even going up beyond that if you have to buy your insurance in the individual market. So I'm glad that the senator from Nevada has offered this amendment. I'm anxious to see how the other side votes on the amendment that the senator from New Hampshire has offered that would guarantee that these Medicare savings would go back into Medicare and not be used to pay for a new government entitlement program at a cost of $2.5 trillion to the American taxpayer.